The left thinks it could be the trial of the century. The right says it's a show trial. The president says it's a witch hunt. Paul Manafort, short-time campaign chairman for Donald Trump in 2016, could go to prison for the rest of his life on charges of tax evasion and financial crimes which occurred 2 or 3 years before Manafort had anything to do with Donald Trump. Does this first trial resulting from the special counsel investigation by Robert Mueller hold real significance for the future of the now 15-month-old investigation? Will President Trump be caught in a dragnet? Will Manafort spill whatever beans there are to spill on Trump? And what could come of it? Joining us to analyze the political significance of the Manafort trial is LibertyNation.com managing editor Mark Angelides. So, Mark, welcome. And it seems certain that Paul Manafort would not have been held accountable for these alleged crimes had he not worked for Donald Trump. And yet, the prosecution appears to have a mountain of evidence that Manafort did some highly illegal things. Most of it corroborated in open court by his partner, Rick Gates, who's pled guilty to similar charges and flipped on Manafort in hopes of saving himself. So, is this a purely political prosecution, or is Mueller correct to prosecute alleged crimes like this, which he comes across in the course of his probe, even if they're not directly related to the heart of the investigation?
Hey, Tim, thanks for having me. The answer is, unfortunately, it's not an either-or question. Is it a political prosecution? Yes, absolutely. Is Mueller right to prosecute for crimes that he's come across in the course of investigation? Absolutely he is. I mean, nobody wants to live in a society where if it doesn't fit the political narrative, then we should just ignore a particular crime. I mean, if Paul Manafort has committed these crimes, then he should be held accountable for them. But the question remains, what has Mueller got to do with this? Why not pass it off? I mean, he said himself that there's no inquiry into obstruction of justice here. His exact words when he's putting the filing papers in. So, I mean, any of these alleged crimes, they were committed before he joined the Trump campaign. So there's also no Russian collusion involved in this particular proceedings. So there's no good reason for this to be in any way connected to Trump. So why is Mueller dealing with it directly? This should have been passed off to a prosecutor, and he should be carrying on with his investigation. So either he's trying to drag it out, I don't know, for some unknown future date, let's just say November 2018, just for example, or he's trying to connect the crimes of Manafort, no matter if they have anything to do with the Russian collusion or obstruction of justice investigation, with Donald Trump for political gain. It's political. Absolutely. And yes, he should be prosecuted for crimes he's committed if he committed them.
Now, you bring up an interesting point. You said he could have just referred this case to a U.S. attorney. And that's exactly what he did in the case of Michael Cohen. And those who think that Michael Cohen is going to uncover some smoking gun dirt on Donald Trump seem to forget that if Robert Mueller had such a thing or had any amount of dirt that could assist in getting Donald Trump, he wouldn't have referred the case of Cohen to the U.S. attorney in the Southern District of New York. And in this case, it appears he has nothing linking Trump to any of the crimes that Manafort's being tried for. So I guess in a sense, it seems like Mueller may have it backwards. Maybe he could get more out of Cohen and should have kept him, you know, in his purview and referred the Manafort case. I don't know. What do you think?
Well, actually, it's quite an obvious, if you think about it, it's quite an obvious plan. You see, if it all comes from Mueller, then it looks like, as Donald Trump says, it looks like it's a politically motivated witch hunt. But if it's coming from multiple directions, it really looks like that there's so many things that have just all of a sudden stumbled upon this. Oh, look what Donald Trump's been doing. And people forget that the Cohen investigation is really, it's part of the same investigation. But by having it tried in a different court by different prosecutors, it makes it look as though many things are coming in at once. It's all very much smoke and mirrors.
I see what you're saying. So you're saying that by having the Cohen trial running simultaneous to the Manafort trial, it presents an image that Mueller is coming up with things far and wide, and that Trump is getting in deeper and deeper trouble. As we continue with LibertyNation.com managing editor Mark Angelides joining us from the UK, Mark, the federal judge in this case, T.S. Ellis III, has been very cranky. He has openly criticized the motives of the Mueller team, questioning whether Manafort was essentially just roadkill being used to justify the investigation and used as a way to somehow get to Donald Trump. The judge has admonished the prosecution frequently, yes?
Judge Ellis, he's a real card. In the early stages, he was questioning the practice of squeezing a witness until they sing, and suggested that with this amount of pressure, it's more likely that, in his words, the canary will compose. And I feel that this is perhaps Mueller's aim, trying to put as much pressure on Manafort that even if he knows nothing, or if there is nothing to actually be known, he'll compose something or he'll make something up that can implicate Donald Trump in some way.
Do you see the media trying to present the story of this trial of Manafort as being related to the question of whether Trump colluded with Vladimir Putin and Russian interests?
See, I do see it as that the media is very much involved in this. And this is shown quite simply by how Mueller is almost working hand in hand with the media. I wouldn't say he's actually doing leaks as such. But the fact that they put two separate trials for Manafort's alleged crimes here, it's to keep the interest going. So he's being tried for certain crimes here under Judge Ellis. Now, as you mentioned in your wonderful article on LibertyNation.com, go and check it out, the listeners, that the trial is likely to conclude in a couple of weeks. What this means is that it can all be gone and it will be forgotten before people get to the polls in the November midterms.
For sure.
But with another case coming up about the same guy, very similar crimes that are being addressed, then they can keep this alive in the media. There's no other reason to try him twice.
All right. On that note, I thank you, Mark, for joining us from all the way over in the UK. Thanks.